Everybody, welcome back. Glad you guys made it. If you have seen any of the past videos, especially the ones I've done recently, I've been trying to have a little bit more fun, try to showcase my personality a little bit more for the camera, and that's been fun, and that's what I hope to achieve. This video is gonna be a little bit different and a little bit more serious. As some of you may or may not know, May is Mental Health Awareness Month. So when I first started this channel, I wanted to talk about mental health, addiction, happiness, positivity, all that stuff. What I noticed is it kind of went in a little bit different direction, which I'm okay with, but that was my purpose for creating this channel. It was giving me an outlet to do something creative, something to put my mind to, keep me going, keep me creative. As far as my experience with mental illness, about 5 years ago in 2014, I had went into a year's worth of deep depression. Had some things kind of go on in my life that when you put them all together back to back, it was just a lot for me to handle and to take in. Something that I've experienced myself, something I've been through, something that I recognize a lot more in people now that I've been through that and I've had my own experience. I knew that something wasn't right. I knew that something was off up here, but I couldn't pinpoint it and I couldn't put a finger on it to know exactly what was what. I didn't really have an understanding of depression and anxiety prior to that. It really took this situation for me to fully understand and fully grasp what those things are and how powerful they can be over somebody. So when I was going through my depression, I was constantly researching how, what, where, when, why, solutions, all these different things. What I did very early on in that was I got a notebook. If any of you know me or have watched any of the past videos, you know that writing is important to me, whether you do it as a hobby or professionally. It's just a great release to have. So what I did was I put together this notebook. In my research, anytime I found little tips, little quote, any helpful piece of information, I copied it into this notebook. So I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of what's inside here. And this is just an idea. It was something that was beneficial to me that I could look to and say, okay, I need to be doing these things or I need to start incorporating these ideas into my daily life. So that's what I did. I created this notebook and it's just different tools, 18 steps to become mentally strong. So just some different tips that you can try, and they're really helpful. Here we have 5 things that happy people do in the morning. A couple little steps that you can practice every morning to get yourself in a better mind state. So yeah, you have all sorts of different things. Some very inspirational words from the Dalai Lama. Just some different tips and ideas to take care of yourself. Some self-help for depression. Quotes. 12 ways to heal stress. Some more quotes. 10 pieces of timeless wisdom to help you get through hard times. It's just a collection of all sorts of, like I said, little lists, little tips, tricks, quotes, all things that I put together in this book. That way, when I was really struggling with the day or I really needed a pick me up or something to remind me what I'm doing, what my goal is, this book right here. A lot of cool stuff I put in here, and you can create your own. Super simple. A pen and a paper, markers, you can color it up, make it fancy. However you want to do it, I just wanted it to be a nice reference for me that I could go back to, look at, check myself, make sure that I was doing everything that I should be doing to pull myself out of a state of depression. So that's very helpful. What I ask of you guys to do today with this video is to reach out to your friends and family and loved ones and make sure you're checking on them. Make sure that they're not showing those symptoms of depression. Make sure that they know that there is help out there. There is a better way. Things will get better. I would have never thought that 5 years ago when I was in a super deep state of depression. I would have never thought that I would be at least able to do this now. I'm still learning. I'm still growing. I'm still battling every day, but I'm in a far better place now than I was then. And I would have never thought that, being in that state of mind that I was in back then. I'm particularly grateful for the people around me that were able to recognize that and listen when I called out to them and that helped out in any way that they could. I'm forever grateful for that. And I appreciate that because this story could have ended a whole lot different. I had to basically strip myself down to my core, to the rock bottom, and it took me time to kind of relearn myself and what things actually made me happy, not what I was doing for somebody else or trying to find happiness in other ways, any other avenue except for right here. And I'm still working on practicing that. I'm not perfect and an expert in no way, and I don't think anybody really is. We're all on this quest to be better people. One of the things that I learned particularly about depression and anxiety is a lot of the symptoms are the same. It's very recognizable in different people, even though what got us to that position may have been completely different things. But the end result is it's still those same feelings. It's still the same symptoms. All of that's the same. To me, it's easy to identify that in others now that I've experienced it. It's clear as day to me now. It's a huge red flag when I see some of those symptoms being exhibited by people around me. All right, guys, I just want to wish you guys the best. Make sure whatever you're doing it for your own happiness, for yourself. It's okay to be selfish in that regard. We got to water our own grass before we can make somebody else's grass greener. And that's just the truth of the matter. If you're not happy with yourself, you'll never be happy. There's no amount of money. There's no fancy car, big house, dream job, dream spouse, none of that. None of that will matter or make a difference unless you're happy in here. That takes work. That's something you got to work on, just like when you exercise or practice a hobby of yours or anything like that. You build strength, and you have to do that for yourself and for your happiness as well. Nobody's gonna do it for you. You're not gonna find it anywhere. It's not just gonna come magically and happen. You have to put some work in. You gotta put the effort in. You gotta wanna make a change for a happier you. It's totally, totally, totally doable. Even one small step at a time makes a difference. And all it would take is just these little small steps. And slowly but surely, I was able to pull myself out of that and start building myself back up. That's all it took. It was a series of small little steps, little accomplishments, little achievements, little goals that allowed me to keep progressing and keep moving forward. Granted, I still have work to do. I've come a long way from where I was, and that was a really dark place. And I knew something wasn't right, and I knew something was off. I had to make a change for myself. I had to look within and redo some things and correct some things. Kind of why I titled this vlog Never Ending Quest. We're always looking to get better, always can evolve, always can learn. It doesn't matter how old or young you are, there's always things that we can learn out there to better ourselves. So I hope that you're finding your happiness and your peace, and you're able to do the things that make you mentally strong and mentally healthy. If you recognize others around you that are suffering from some of those things or exhibiting some of those symptoms, then I call on you to reach out to that person, try to help them, get them the help. If you want to fix yourself, you have to want it for yourself. You have to take the steps necessary to progress yourself. All right, guys, I just wanted to give you a little bit of history on why mental health is so important to me, something that I've experienced, something I've seen others go through, and it's tough. It's not easy, but things do get better. Things will get better. Things do pass. So again, guys, make sure you're checking on your family, checking on your friends, checking on your loved ones, and making sure that they're all right. All right, guys, until next time, peace.